Okay, guys, we have this model in Tekla structure and we want to import this model to our Revit project to, for example, model the architectural elements according to this. In Tekla, you need to go to the file menu here and in here, click on export and I'm going to export this in IFC. You can work with IFC4, it is a newer version of IFC and it will work better. So click on IFC4 and from here, select a file name here, for example, str-ifc. And also you have some templates here, but the best template for integration, in my opinion, is a standard one. So click the standard and let me put the name str-ifc. And then you need to select the folder. I'm going to save it on my desktop here. And then you can specify the location of this. I'm going to work with model origin. I want all of the objects, not some selected objects. And then object color by object class. You can make it by standard, by actual elevation and other kind of standards. And it is up to you, but this is great. And also you can name the layers by name and phase. The name is better. And also the format, you can use IFC zip and also you can IFC. For Revit, we need IFC. And also in export type, we have these ones. Because I'm going to work with this as a reference, I'm going to select this one. If you are using in more advanced way, you can use design transfer view. Okay, all of these are great. And okay, and then I don't want the beam as a plate. And these are good for me. So click on export. You need to wait a little bit and your model will be exported in the specified location. Okay, now here you can open the directory of this and also you can watch the log file here to see the exact report. You have the number of IFC beam, the number of assembly and other elements. Let's go to the Revit and let me insert this as a model. Let me create a new model here. Going to use metric architectural template, click on OK. In Revit, you can easily import that file with going to the insert file and from here, click on link IFC and select the file you have exported from the Tekla structure and click on open. Now you will have the file. You need to wait a little bit until Revit would do the processes for you. It may take a little bit longer at the first time, but after loading for the first time, it will be much smoother for second approach. Okay, now we have the model in Revit, and also we will have the levels too to use them. One tip here, Tekla structure models are really heavy for Revit because they have many parts. If you want just use their, for example, border references, and you don't need the connections or something like that, it is a better approach to optimize them and delete the unnecessary files before importing them into Revit. Okay, this is from the integration between Tekla and Revit. Let's see how we can export our Revit files for the Tekla structure. It is really it's the same. For example, you can optimize this model with deleting these because we don't need them in the Tekla structure. And now let me delete these two. And now I can go to the file menu and again go to the export and from here export the IFC file. You can specify the place. Let me put it on arc IFC and then you can modify the setup. For example, you can put in all of these definition sets and sets of adjustment, but for me, the design transfer will work for me. So click on OK. And OK, you can also check the settings there, but it will do the work for me, and click on export. And you need to wait a little bit, and then you can have your architectural IFC file, and then you can import it easily into your TechLite structure. Okay, our architectural model has been generated, so we can use it on our in our TechLite model. I've created a new TechLite model here. To use IFC files, you need to go to the sidebar here and click on reference models, and in here click on add model and choose the standard one and browse your file. Let's go to the desktop, and this is my IFC file, and you can choose the group of that, your location and your offset, and also your scale, and many more items that you can check them, and there are they are descriptive, so I don't need to describe. And then click on add model. You need to wait a little bit, and then you will have the model in here. Okay, I'm going to expand my working area, and now you can see I have the model here in my Tekla structure. Now I can create my grids according to this one, and then we are good to go to create our columns and beams according to the architectural